Today we're doing even more slicing and dicing, using and abusing. It's like Recip Saw Week on the TRZ channel. We are going to put the 36-volt LXT Makita Recip Saw up against the all-new DeWalt 60-volt Flexi Sexy. It's going to be a head-to-head competition. Only one can win. Now this is the all-new 389, not the 88. This one's actually supposed to have 19% more power than the previous model, but is it enough to beat the Makita? We got treated 6x6 lumber right here. We're going to slice and dice through, but we're going to look at the specs also, see the price ranges of both of them, what these have to offer, what some of them are lacking, and just who's all in out more powerful and faster. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the DeWalt, and then we'll move it over to the Makita. We'll talk about all its specs, and then we're going to slice and we're going to dice. Today we're using a 9A8 Sexy Flexi battery on this saw. Overall build quality of the DeWalt, it is excellent. Very heavy duty, well made. I'm very happy with that. You do have that really thick overmold protection made out of rubber, so if you do bust it off against the concrete, well, you don't really have to worry about damage. You got the variable speed trigger and the LED light. The one thing that I absolutely love about this recip saw, and probably better than any other one that I've used, is the quick release. So easy to do. All you gotta do is pull that little lever there, and now you can simply take that blade out, let go, and then pull back up, and you can install another one. Super, super easy, super, super quick. They did an excellent job on that. However, you are going to miss a few key features on this saw. What? No orbital? Okay, but what about the Raptor hook? What? No Raptor hook? But surely you have to, what? No adjustable shoe? Oh man, a lot of key features on this recip saw just plainly missing. The one feature I told you I love, that quick release, quick insert, but unfortunately, that's really all you're getting on this. You do got a ton of power though. The one thing I will also say about this saw, it is very, very smooth. I have never felt this saw bogged down ever once while cutting. But is that enough to beat the Makita? Now, let's talk a couple specs on this saw. 1,874 unit watts, 15.5 pounds it has listed on the depot site. I'm assuming that's with the battery. Overall, you know, other than pretty heavy, it's balanced really well. You got the 3,000 strokes per minute, stroke length 1 1/8 inches. You're looking at $299 for the charger, the 9.0 battery, and the saw itself. And I believe you have a 3-year warranty on them. Now let's move it over to the Makita. Already did a tool duel with the Super Sawzall from Milwaukee, but what about this saw here? What does it offer and what does it lack? One of the issues with this saw is, well, some people don't really care for the dual battery platform. You have to have two batteries in the saw to run it, not just one. Of course, do the math, 18 volt plus 18 volt brings you out to 36 volt. Me personally, I don't know how I feel about it. How do you feel about the dual battery on the Makita? Let me know in the comment section below, curious. On the saw, you do have the Raptor hook, you do not have an adjustable shoe, and you do not have the orbital action. However, you do have a slim taper right here up in the front of the saw that really allows you to hold on to this thing. It's extremely comfortable. You also got the quick change, quick release blade right here. All you gotta do is pull that over, turn it, and it stays open. It's a really good system. Not as good as the DeWalt's, but still very good. You got the LED light right there, and you got this speed adjustment right here. You got the 1 and 2 setting plus your lock. So you got 1, the low setting, 2, the high setting, and you also got the variable speed trigger. So that's really nice, offers a little bit more control. Build quality I think is great. A lot of people saying they don't like the seam right down the middle. It looks kind of cheap to them, but all right. Definitely a lot better for the overhead work. Just feels lighter all in all. I also like how they designed that trigger because when you're in an awkward area, it's just easier to pull. It goes up and around so you can really get your finger in there. Now, if you wanted to buy this in a kit, you could get the dual charger with 2 5AH batteries, the saw for around $349. So it's definitely a little bit more expensive than the DeWalt. There's one other issue with the Makita as well. It's that pesky Makita Gnome. Check it out. I got him on film again. Listen here, Makita Gnome. I've been doing videos for you and giving good... You know what? I'm so tired of you thinking you're too... How dare you? So tired of your attitude. What, you think this is funny? You know what? Come here! I'm gonna get you, Makita Gnome. Ah, pesky Makita Gnome. All right, let's do some cutting. DeWalt on the left, the Makita on the right. Remember, either one of these have the orbital action, but the Makita just slicing and dicing so much faster than the DeWalt. That is crazy to me. Now, the DeWalt's actually in my dominant hand, but we're gonna switch it up. We're gonna make it that the DeWalt's on the right side Again, the Makita just coming out swinging on that DeWalt. Not sure why. It is just insanity how much quicker that this saw is compared to the DeWalt. Now let me say, that DeWalt never ever bogs down, never gives me issues starting. It will cut, but it's just a lot slower than every saw that we put up against it. Maybe if I turn that radio on, play some music, you know, that DeWalt will get into the groove of things. Oh, that's that 100,000 subscriber. Yeah, I forgot about that being there. Don't forget to subscribe. We're doing it again though. We got the Makita on the left, the DeWalt on the right. And we're really not rocking these. We're just going straight down. And man, that Makita is just killing that DeWalt. Now these both have 3,000 strokes per minute. You're looking at 10 pounds with both batteries in that Makita, and you do have the 1.25 stroke length on it, but the speed comparison on both of these saws is just, I don't get it. I mean, the DeWalt, I mean, it's such a powerful saw, but it's just so slow. This is the thing, DeWalt definitely needed to add an orbital action on this saw. It's just a plain Jane. I mean, if you're making some basic simple cuts, that's great, but it's just a slow saw. It's a great build on this saw, and there's a lot of power on it. It's just missing the adjustable shoe, which so does the Makita. You're missing the rafter hook. You don't have the orbital. It just, it leaves me scratching my head, where at least the Makita has the rafter hook, and it does feel, even though there's no orbital action in quotes, it does feel like there's sort of an orbital action going on with it. You know, 19% more power than the 8.8, yeah, that's great, but it's missing. It's just missing. And, you know, when I did this review on this saw, the independent review, we did have an engineer from DeWalt saying that they're looking into the issues and they might, you know, fix them. So I'm hoping that's the case, because this saw could be so much better than what it is. You know, Makita, I got to give it to Makita on this one. You know, whether or not you have the two batteries or not, it was just a better saw at the end of the day. And that's just my opinion. So DeWalt's got to step it up with the recip saws. Now that said, I'm curious to know what you think. Whether you're a DeWalt or a Makita fan, or maybe you're a Milwaukee fan or a Rigid Octane fan or whatever, who won this? I want to know what you think. I love hearing your feedback in the comments section. But for me, I'm going with Makita all day long, even if the Makita Gnome sucks. Now, if you like this video, please smash that like button. Get subscribed and hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any more of these tool duels. We're heading for the 100,000 subscriber mark, so would love to have you as part of the team. I'll put both links for these tools in the description below. Again, I love having you by. Thanks for stopping. We'll be back with more videos soon.